Hello and welcome to another episode of Supercalifunnelistic with me, Christian Rauchenwald. In today's episode, I'm going to show you how you can easily improve the search engine rankings of your funnels or any other website for that matter. Now, if you already researched a little bit about how to improve the search engine rankings of your funnels hosted as ClickFunnels, you'll probably already figured out that ClickFunnels only covers the basic options like adding a featured image, a description, and a title tag that will or will not show up on Google. However, ClickFunnels page editor creates your page with a structure that is not optimized for search engines like Google, Yahoo, and so on. And therefore, chances of your funnels ranking very well on Google are slim to none. But that doesn't mean that it's not worth the effort of spending a couple of minutes on each of your funnels to at least increase the chance of your funnels to rank on Google and other search engines as well. And as said, this method works for any other website, but in this video, I'm going to show you specifically how you can do it with your funnels hosted at ClickFunnels. Now, the secret method that I'm going to show you in this video on how to improve the ranking of your funnels or any other website for that matter is called structured data. It's something that you can add to the source code of your website that will provide Google and other search engines with detailed information about your page or funnel. That information can be information about you or your business, or it can also be information about reviews on the page or things like product information. Now, don't worry, you don't have to write any source code yourself or even understand how it's written. All you have to do is check out the link in the description below to the markup generator, which I will show you in a moment, and then add that generated markup to the source code of your website or funnel. And in terms of funnel, keep watching and I'll show you how to do it with ClickFunnels. Now, as you can see here, I have opened one of the many markup generators that are out there. If you don't like this specific one, just Google for markup generator and you will find different generators that may suit you better or maybe easier to use. With this generator, we can create different markup for articles, breadcrumbs, events, FAQ pages, how-tos, job posts, local business information, organizations, persons, products, recipes, videos, and website markup. There's a bunch of more of those things, but in the end, in most cases, all you will need for your funnels is actually the product markup and eventually the organization markup. So I'm going to start with the product markup here by simply selecting it, and it will load the input fields that I need to fill in. So what you want to fill in is the information about your product. So let's say you have a funnel promoting ClickFunnels One Funnel Away Challenge. In that case, we would say the name is One Funnel Away Challenge. The image URL is something that we don't have as of right now. We're going to get back to that in a moment. The brand would be ClickFunnels. Identification properties, we don't have any product number or something that you would have for a physical product. The product description, that's up to you, but I'm just going to write 30-day challenge right now. The offer type, it's a regular offer. The URL would be either the URL of your post or your affiliate link. I'm just going to add google.com here for right now. The price would be in US dollars and the regular price is $100, but if you know how, you can actually sign up for $47, which provides you with a benefit because it will stand out to people that know that the regular price is $100. The price is valid forever, actually. The availability is in stock or online only in that case, for example. Item condition would be not specified or new. And then we get to the ratings. You could say the average rating out of 5 stars would be 4.9 out of 2000 ratings. Highest value 5, lowest value 0. And those numbers are not invented. Those are actually the numbers of reviews that were previously listed on ofareview.com. And that's pretty much it. So once you have that, all you have to do is press the copy button. Again, we're missing the image URL. So I'm actually just gonna go to Google image search right now and look for One Funnel Away Challenge. You should obviously not just copy images from Google, but use your own images or the ones provided in the ClickFunnels affiliate dashboard in that case. Copy the image address and go back here and edit here. If we wanted to, we could also add single reviews to that markup by clicking add review and providing the additional information, like for example, my name is Christian Rauchenwald. My rating for the challenge is 5 stars. The date for the challenge, I'm just gonna pick anything. And here would be my amazing review. And obviously I'm also the author of that review and it would be published on my page, which would be published by my company. Like this. So once that's done, all we have to do is click the copy button on top, go to your ClickFunnels account and to the funnel where you want to add that markup, and then open the sales page or whichever the bridge page, whichever page you want to add it to in the page editor. Now, if you're running a split test, you will need to do that for both pages, for the control page and for the variation page. And what you need to do is you just need to go to settings, tracking code, and there in the header or the footer, doesn't really matter. Paste that code and save it. Now, once that's done, you can open the preview of your page and copy the page URL and then simply open the Google Structured Data Testing Tool and enter the URL here and click on Run Test. This will fetch the preview version of the page and it will grab the markup that you added and show you if everything is correct. So you see we have 3 warnings here. It actually would like to have a price valid until. Yeah, it's a recommended field, but it's not required. So if you have warnings, it's perfectly fine. Only errors are something that you should not have. And as you can see, it also complains that there's no global identifier for the product. So we don't have like a ISBN or a barcode or anything else like that. Now we can also click on preview, which is not available for all the markups, but for many it is. And you will see how it would look like on Google. Now, as you can see, if our page were to show up on the Google search result, it would now stand out a little bit more because it would have the 5-star rating shown. It would show it as 1 review because we only added 1 review, which overrode the 2000 review numbers that we added before, and it would show the price of $47. Now, if you put this into perspective of a regular Google search result page like this one with a bunch of different results, you will see that the additional information provided here, the 5 stars showing up, will simply make your search results stand out more to people and therefore increase your click rate. Now there's other markup that you can add, for example, FAQ questions, which will then show up eventually like this, and which obviously will make your search results stand out even more. This in return, again, will increase the click rate, so the number of people that actually click on the result, and therefore it will show Google that your result is more valuable and will keep pushing it up into the search result rankings. This works for your funnels. It also works for your regular websites. It pretty much works for every page where you are able to add some kind of code to the page. And again, there's a bunch of different markups out there. So you can add FAQ entries, which would show up like this. You can add product information with reviews like we just did, which will eventually show up like this example here, showing the amount of ratings and the stars, providing an additional visual incentive for people are drawing attention to that search result and increasing the click-through rate. And the best about it is you can combine multiple structured data on the same page. So you can create 1 structured data set about your company slash organization. You can create 1 about the product that you're selling or promoting on this page. You can create 1 or multiple with reviews. You can create multiple FAQ entries and so on. And you provide search engines with additional information that will increase the chance of your page or funnel ranking better on Google. And the best thing is it only takes you a couple of minutes to do so. And as mentioned before, you can do this with pretty much any website you have. Now, what would be the best practice here to do so you have the least possible effort but the highest possible outcome? It's quite simple. Install a Chrome extension like SEO Surfer. You can find a link to it in the description down below, and then go to Google. Now, in our example, we were creating markup for the One Funnel Away challenge. So we're gonna stay with this. And in that case, I'm searching for One Funnel Away challenge. Now, what I will see is similar search results thanks to the browser extension that we just installed. But when you scroll down, you will also see what other people are looking for. Now you want to make sure that you add FAQ markups for those questions. What is the one funnel away challenge? How much is the one funnel away challenge? How does ClickFunnels work? Obviously make sure that the questions fit the topic on the page because you want to get the right traffic to your page. And the beauty of it here is once you expand one of the questions, it will load additional questions down below. So you can pick as many as you feel like and simply go back to the structured data generator and create the structured data for an FAQ page and simply add question one, answer one, and so on for all the questions that you found within the search results here, and add that markup to your funnels or website as well. This will increase your chance for your funnel or page to show up for any of those pages. Now, once you've covered the questions that you found here, you can also go through the additional searches that Sales Surfer or the Sales Surfer Google Chrome extension shows you. Instead of searching for one funnel away challenge, just search for one funnel away and do the same thing. Scroll down to see people also may ask. Now you can keep doing this as long as you want for as many questions as you like. As said, don't forget you can combine markup on one page. You can have product markup for multiple products on the same page. You can have review markups for multiple reviews on the same page and so on. The important part is just do it. Take the time for each of your funnels, sales and order pages to create the markup for product and FAQ and whatever other markup you seem fitting. In the end, it will only take you a couple minutes to do for each of your pages, but it will increase the chance of your funnels and websites to show up on Google search results and to rank better, which in turn will drive you more organic traffic, which will equal free money because you didn't have to pay for the traffic. Even if your funnel is converting horribly, in the end, it's just a numbers game. The more people go to your page, the more people will buy, sign up, or click on your affiliate link. So I hope this helps you. Don't forget, if you have any questions about any of this, leave a comment down below. Also, let me know if you already have been adding the structured data markup to your funnels or if it's the first time you learned about this. And don't forget, if you took anything positive away from the video, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button so you don't miss our next videos. Thanks for watching. See you next week with another episode of Supercalifunnelistic. Till then, bye-bye.